Good day, mates. Welcome to the Valencia Bonita Club and Sports Center. It is a beautiful, beautiful winter day. Well, no, actually, it's a spring day, but early spring at that. And the palm trees are swaying in the breeze, and I'm going to take you on a walk and talk through what is, in all likelihood, going to be where I call home for the foreseeable future. Well, not actually the immediate foreseeable future, because my home won't be ready until about this time next year. But anyway, I'm going to take you for a walk and talk through what is just absolutely a gorgeous facility. I had the opportunity to walk through here yesterday in conjunction with looking at a home that I'm thinking about purchasing, and I thought, why not come back with the real camera, if you will, and do a walk and talk through what is really just a gorgeous community. So let's go on inside, and you'll see just how spectacular this place is. Well, hello, Bonita Springs. Look at this entrance. Does this entrance make a great first impression? Oh, boy. Look at this place. You know, if you gotta grow old, this looks like a pretty good place to do that. What a gorgeous place this is. Just over there, you've got resident services. And look at the chandeliers right there. Wow. Really a beautiful place. So before going down there, I don't know if there's anything down this way. Perhaps there is. But let's just take a look. You've got your restrooms off to the left. Very nice. Just pristine. This is just a gorgeous place. Over here, you actually have a cooking school. You see, it's a cooking studio is what they call it. Look at that. So you come in and the chef will stand up there. I don't know if it's Gordon Ramsay or Guy Fieri, but who knows? You know, there's your place where you're gonna learn how to cook right there. And then, I'm not quite sure what is up here. Well, this is looks like this is the kitchen. You see, they've got kitchen here with some refrigerators. Perhaps you've got your lending library. This is probably where you come. That's the catering kitchen. That's actually what they call it. And then over here, look at this. Look at this facility. Is that beautiful? And here you see they have look at the stage. They could have a Broadway performance here, I was told. And here's the dance floor. See, New Year's Eve. Beautiful. Look at the stage. Wow. You see, I once heard life as a stage. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to thank you all for coming tonight. We have a very special evening programmed for you. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. Our first act is Tamo from Toowoomba. Okay, so here would be the bar right back here. Mosey on up and ask them if they have any non-alcoholic beer, which hopefully they do. So let's come back out here. Now they have just a gorgeous restaurant here. Look at this. Beautiful. Isn't this gorgeous? Let's take a look inside this restaurant. It's called Zest. Wow. Beautiful. What a difference a day makes. That's an appropriate song. the bar. The wonderful bar. Fantastic. Table for two, please. Over here you have a nice fireplace. Sit and have a nice cocktail while you're waiting for your dinner. Maybe have a little appetizer. I don't know how well you can actually see that. Maybe if I come closer. Very nice. And I'll have that same fireplace in my living room. Now down here, come down here, you actually have the spa. Look at this hallway. Oh, it's gorgeous. The hallway just seems to go on forever. Here are some of the events. Jimmy Keys, Saturday, March 20th, comedian musician Jimmy Keys, high energy variety show. Let's see. Spa services. Very nice. Vinny and Vinay. Over here they have a sports lounge. Look at this. See? It's closed at the moment. But this would be the sports lounge here. Play yourself some billiards, poker. Very nice. Now I'm a little bit further. We got another card room right over here. This is a card room. Oh, this is just a beautiful place. Over here they have a kiln room for pottery. See, they have a fishing club, a book club, a garden club, a yappy hour, ladies lunch bunch. Look at all of this. Jewelry making club. And they have the paint. There's the paint club. Cooking club. A lot of stuff. Look at the spa. Here's the spa right here. Wow. Beautiful. Hello, how are you?
Hi.
Beautiful. Really, really gorgeous. Can I have a chocolate? Thank you. And here's your nail salon. Can you look at that? Look at that nail salon. Oh, that's wonderful. Okay. Very nice. Probably get a massage there. Alright, so actually I'm going to see if I can't just step out. Perhaps this way. Maybe this will take me to the pool area. Wonderful. Here's the fire pit area. Here they've got two beautiful fire pits here. Look at that. Come down in the evening, have yourself a drink. Oh, fantastic. Very, very nice. See if we can't find our way into the pool. Look at all the artwork here. Now, I don't know if the art club, I don't know if somebody from the Valencia Bonita Art Club did that painting or not. Very nice. We got a bar right here. Boy, talk about a bar. Look at this. Isn't that nice? Fantastic. Here's the pool. One of what I believe is four actually five pools here. It's like going on, vacation. See, look at that. Looks like it's 4 feet, 9 inches at its deepest. There's your pool. There's a reserve off in the backdrop there. This is the, well, it looks like a walking pool. You come in and walk around. See that? Very nice. Very, very nice. Fantastic. Wow. So there's one, two. One, I think over here you'll see your third pool. And it's just a very laid back atmosphere here. Not a lot of people running around screaming, you know, music. This is nice. Look at this lap pool. Wow. Wonderful. Boy, this looks nice. Now I'll be watching this video probably for the next year. I'll be watching this video for the next year. And now look at this couple over here. Good day, mates.
Hey, mate.
You mind saying hello?
I don't mind at all.
I'm Tomo. I've been spending the last year in Australia hiding out from this crazy thing called COVID and all the stuff. And I have a home up in Fort Myers in Paseo, and I sold the home, and I'm looking for a place to grow old. And somebody said, you know, mate, you want to go grow old at Valencia Bonita.
Yeah.
That's where you want to grow old.
Well, that sounds like a smart person who gave you that advice.
Do you live here?
We do, yes.
What's your name?
Should I put my mask on? Is that a
good one? That's okay. That's all right.
My name's Glenn.
Glenn?
Yes.
Debbie.
And you are? Husband and wife?
Yes. You are?
How'd you score such a pretty lady?
I've been very lucky.
People told me if I buy a house here, I might get a woman as beautiful as her.
Yeah.
Huh? Is that how you did it?
Very lucky.
That's how you did it,
and
huh?
And you would also be lucky to live here, I think.
How long have you lived here?
Was it 2 years, I think?
Almost
2 years?
2 years in May.
Yeah.
So, what did you say your name was?
My name is Tom, and I haven't committed yet.
Tom, is it a true story, what you're saying? That you're
it is. Oh, it okay. is. So if you search on YouTube for Tom Hall, you'll find me, okay. H-A-L-L. But when I was talking to a friend, I haven't committed yet. I'm looking at buying the Julia
nice.
Model.
Nice house.
I got a nice lot out in the back.
Uh-huh.
And somebody said, you know, or somebody said I should go online and see what people are saying about this place. And I thought, you know, I'll just go walk around the pool with the camera.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
And see, you were happy with the whole buying process here?
We had a very good experience.
You did?
It, by and large, a 90% great experience.
Wonderful, wonderful.
Yeah, I don't think you can ask for more than that.
Uh-huh.
GL has a great reputation. I have no problem with GL. And the value of our homes seems to be going up by the quarter, by a substantial amount.
Wow, fantastic. So, well, maybe this time next year we'll be sitting at the bar talking about this very same conversation.
There'll be no more COVID.
I haven't done it yet.
Yeah.
All right, sounds good. Well, listen, as they'd say down in Australia, good on you, mate.
Good
all
on
right.
You.
Have a great day. All right. So, all right. So there. Look at that. You see? Seems like a good indication that this is a nice place to live. You know, just kind of a laid back atmosphere. Oh, now we got to go check out the. Let's go check out the fitness club before going over and looking at some of the other amenities like the tennis and the cricket ball. Oh boy. I like it. I really, really like it. I don't know how you could go wrong. You know, how could you go wrong? All right, you ready for a workout? If you are, this is where you'd want to be. You'd want to be here in the fitness club. And you're looking at a facility that's probably the better part of 2 years old. And for all intent and purpose, this equipment looks like it's all of 2 days old. It looks very, very, very nice. Look at this. Isn't that something? Beautiful equipment. Very nice. And interestingly enough, it's 3 o'clock. It's 3 o'clock on a, well, today would be a Thursday. And not many people in here. Wow, very nice. And somewhere in here, there is a room for doing Zumba. Here are some of the classes, you see. There's your Zumba, Wednesday and Friday, in the social hall, fitness center attendant, yoga, aqua fit, total health system services. There's the fitness office. Very nice. Let's go see if we can see where they do the actual Zumba classes. Well, I don't know how well you can see this, but this would be the one of the exercise rooms. You can see its lights are turned off or very dim, and I'm looking through the glasses that can't get in, but there's one room right there. Now I will show you the other here, just across the way. Now here's the other room here, the exercise studio and table tennis, I think also known as ping pong. But I think they have this closed because of the pandemic at the moment, but this gives you still a good opportunity as to just more of the amenities here at this special place. All right, I found my way over to the pickleball and the tennis facility here, as well as the pro shop. You'd be looking at the pro shop right here. I don't know that it's open, but here's the tennis. Look at that. And there's several courts here, numerous courts for playing tennis here at Valencia Bonita. They really have to say, they did a nice job. They really, really did a nice job with this facility. Here's your pickleball here. Look at this.
Nice.
I don't know if these guys are any good or not, but
I'm the only good one.
These guys stink? All right. So this is pickleball. For those of you overseas, this is probably one of the fastest growing sports. Watch this. I'll try to follow the action. Ooh. Ooh. There we go. Oh, there you go. There's your that's pickleball for you folks. That's pickle.
It wasn't on the line?
No, it's good.
Three, it was good. 3-0-2. Okay. So here we go. Watch this. It's kind of like a miniature, kind of like a cross between tennis and ping pong or something like that. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. Oh, yeah. All right. There's your pickleball. And then, wow, look at all these courts over here. All types of tennis courts. Just beautiful. Really, really beautiful. Wow. They actually have, unlike the place that I'm living now, the pickleball has lights. Oh, on this court, look at this. Very nice. Water fountains out here. Boy, they did this right. They did this community right. All right. I think there might have some bocce ball courts here as well. We'll go and go take a look. All right. Now, what community would be complete without a bocce ball? You see? So they've got a rather nice bocce ball set up. Hi. Look at this. So here you've got your bocce ball courts. Two courts? Two bocce ball courts?
Yes.
Okay.
Yep.
So here's your bocce ball, folks. Look at this. And then over here, Over here you have, what do you have over here? I'm not quite sure. Probably more, well, more tennis. Look at this. More tennis. Well, I don't know how many tennis courts they've got. They must have quite a few. And then, so that's your community. That's the recreation here. And, you know, there's a saying that says, you get what you pay for. And this is certainly a, it certainly looks like a value for the money. I gotta tell you, very, very, very nice. And I believe, if I'm not mistaken, they have a, I believe that they have some dog parks over here, somewhere in this vicinity. This is where you'd actually come and pick up your mail, right here. Very nice. All right, so I'm gonna go and maybe I can share the dog park with you. I think the dog park, or dog parks, maybe plural, is located just over to the left of the club and sports center. So we'll go see if we can't see the dog parks. I wonder, kind of curious, you know, why they always have, you know, dog parks and not cat parks. You would think that it would only be appropriate, if not fair, you know, to have cat parks for, you know, cat lovers. But being a dog lover myself and not a cat person, I'm not really gonna complain or go to the, you know, monthly HOA meeting and propose a cat park. You know, I don't know how well that would go over. Maybe I could suggest a cat club. You know, maybe there could be a cat club that wouldn't be as costly as developing a cat park, per se. But anyway, let's go see if we can find the dog park. Well, here's your dog park right here. And It's not just your ordinary dog park. It's not like just a big park where you come and just let the dog run loose. No. They got actually stuff that you could. They got stuff that you could have the dogs play on. So they have one section for medium to large dogs over 25 pounds only. So this is medium to large dogs. And then on the other side, they've got small dogs. Isn't that something? Now look at this. Now I would imagine that if there's a gentleman named Skip Smith, and Skip's probably gonna look at this and say, screw the dogs. I wanna play here. You see? Oh boy. What a nice place. Look at this. You know, you'd almost want to go and buy yourself a dog, you know? Now, I don't know if Skip Smith could fit through that. No, but he'd probably want to try. I know he would certainly want to put this to use right here. You see, there's no doubt about that. I'm sure Skipper would probably want to put that to use. But he might get in trouble for doing it. But here is your small dog section right over here as well. So, all right, folks, have a good day. And Skipper, you know I love you, all right? So take good care.